Hello friends, now we were discussing an essay of dramatic poetry by John Dryden. We saw, we had four lectures, three lectures. You remember that, no? First introduction, second overview, and then we also saw what Crates had to say about the ancients, the superiority of the ancients. Now comes the turn of Lycidius. He wants to say that the French are really superior to the English and even to the ancients. That's what he's trying to say. But before entering into the plus points or praising the French as a prelude, means as an introduction, he is trying to find out trying to tell us the defects or the faults of the English stage. And he begins like this. He says, 40 years ago, if you are reading the text, you will see, 40 years ago, he says, the English was superior to all the other stages. Stages means drama, dramatic arts. For example, that was the age of Bowman and Fletcher and also Johnson. But now, at present, what has happened is that the muse of dramatic arts has already migrated to France, and there was a great patron of arts, especially dramatic art, that was Cardinal Richelieu. Cardinal Richelieu himself was a very rich person, even richer than the King of France, and so he had got enough funds will be a very small word for that, enough resources. So he supported and he was the patron of great French dramatists like Corneille and Molière. So he says, at present, English stage is very poor. English stage is full of faults. And one of the faults that he says is, first he says this, English has got a double plot. Double plot. While Aristotle has said it is tragedy is an imitation of an action. When you have got double plot, what happens is you have no time to develop either the main plot. You don't have time or you don't have leisure to touch or to develop the both the plots together. So one will become what is called as subservient to the first one, or the dramatist may not get time to look after this. We never too many things, no? It is very difficult to look after the first and second. And another point he says is that there will be too many characters, and the characters don't know each other. The characters, he says, the Lycidius says, they are like Montagues and Capulets. Montagues and Capulets, you know, they are two warring families in Shakespeare's play, Romeo and Juliet. Romeo and Juliet. There are two families, you know, fighting. So the characters are like that. They don't know each other. And at the end of the play, a crowd, you know, there will be mob on the stage. So absolutely no control, he says. It is something like a small, or something like a kind of mob without any shape. Shapeless mob. It was too many characters. There were two plots. The dramatist has attended to both. And therefore, the incidents are also. There's no logical connection between the happenings in the drama. Something happens there, then something happens here. You have to put your brain, you have to put your efforts to see what is happening where. It is like a three-ring circus. You have heard of three-ring circus. Once upon a time, we had what is called Kamala three-ring circus. The company's name is Kamala Circus. Three-ring means the same thing will be done in three places at the simultaneously. So there's some, you can, if you want, look at there, then there, and this like that. So, but you get confused. So one of the major defects of the English stage is the English dramatists, they have got double plots. And double plot is against the rule given by Aristotle. And there is no decorum of the stage. Too many characters don't know each other. they are like Montagues and Capulets, and at the end of the play, they all of them come together. It is like a mob. So English stage, that's the first fault, is a double plot and its consequences. Secondly, like you to say that the most ridiculous thing about English stage is mixing mirth and passion. Mirth and passion, or what we call tragic comedy. Tragic comedy. He says it is like a, it is, how can you, what's the question? They're contrary things, no? Mirth and passion, how can you mix together? That's practically impossible. And he says it is like a doctor prescribing purgative, and then immediately he prescribes another restringent. Restringent, you know, this a medicine that is given to stop motion. The other is for motion, purgative. So that's what it is like. Purgative. It is play and farce. Play one side and farce another side. Understand? It is like, he says that it is like David with mixing, I mean, giving David the merry humors of Goliath. Imagine that. Imagine David and Goliath fighting, and David becomes a merry person. No? He has lost all his focus to defeat the Goliath. So such a thing is that. So how is it possible? It neutralizes. No? When you are for some day the passion is you become one with that passionate happenings that is on the stage. Immediately you find some people making fun and other things like that. So what happens is there's a neutralization. So according to Aristotle, what is the end of tragedy? End of tragedy is to raise passion and admiration. So how can there be passion and admiration? It is like letting loose. He gives an example like this. It is bedlam on the stage. Bedlam. Group of mad people like that. Some people laughing, some people crying, and some people making fun and the comedy and things like that. So tragic comedy, like he says, it is the worst thing as far as the English stage is concerned. First one we saw two plots. Second one, now it is about tragic comedy, and he says it cannot be so illogical. You cannot just rationalize that, you know. You cannot rationalize the reason behind or why the English people mix tragedy and comedy. And some of these tragic comedies are really failures according to Lycidas, even that of Shakespeare, he says. Understand? And the third the point is that, you know, the third point is, he says, the historical place of Shakespeare. Even Shakespeare are ridiculous, he says. 30 or 40 years of business, events and incidents and battles and things like that, coronation and coup, that is, no, that is throwing a person out of power and so on. Things, all these things in 2.5 hours time. That is really ridiculous. Because you can neither follow the rule of unity of action, nor time, nor place. So, according to him, that is one of the defects of English stage. That is Shakespeare's historical place, or anybody's historical place for that matter. There is a Marlowe also. See, Edward II, you know. Too many incidents and too many characters, minor characters, major characters, so mixing up together. So this is the view of Lycidas, it's not my view, understand? And then the fourth defect is that the English, they have no sense of selection. Selection, see? Horace has given the rule, what's that? That cruel scenes that creates, that can cause aversion in the mind of the spectator should not be presented on the stage. Suppose a father killing his son on the stage. It causes aversion or cruelty. So such things should only be related or narrated. That's what it says. Another advantage of narration is that you can reduce the time. The whole thing is to be presented, means how much time it will take. So you can say something has happened in such and such place. Understand? Johnson, for example, very good. In Magnetic Lady, there is a dinner and there's a quarrel between people. So one of the participants come out and narrate it to the audience. So that the quarrel and their bad words, they are using, abusing each other. Why should we see all these things? No, not required. And if you see that, it will only cause aversion in your mind. Then Lycidas says, it's a comic to see five people and a drum and a shield pass on the stage, come and stand there for some time and then go away from there, saying that it is an army. And there is fencing to a sword fight, and one of them falls dead. He says, is there anything more comic than that? Somebody is falling dead. So presenting the army on the stage, the duels on the stage, and one person dying, Lycidas says, it's impossible. It's comedy, he says. It's not tragedy, it is comedy. The stage is full of people, some of them dying, some of them fighting. What is happening to a person, the actors, we do not know. Ourselves or the actors themselves don't know. That is the situation. Understand? Then he says, the actual thing, the death or dying on the stage can be shown only by Roman gladiators. And they are not just dying for the sake of dying, but they are doing it. Means the actual death is taking place on the stage. That can be, we can understand that. Otherwise, all the other thing, but it is like a stunt in a film and the wrestling match between Bruce Lee and some other person. Wrestling match between Bruce Lee and some other person is real. And you can see, I don't know the names of other wrestlers, I know only Bruce Lee, that's why I'm saying like this. But on the stage, in a film, it is not like that. That is only acting that we know. So, stand on the film and so on. Here the one hero, for example, in our commercial films, just one hero, so he can defeat 100 persons. 50 of them he will kill, and 25 of them will run away, and 25 of them will sit there or in the stage, and they will be showing some comics. What kind of a thing is that? That's what he said. A lot of things can be narrated, as in this case. Understand? So it is ridiculous, he said, to show like this an army, then war between two kingdoms on the stage. Such things can be easily narrated. And English has no sense. That's what he said. So that is the fourth one. And the fifth one, he said that, see, in English films, on the English stage, you find conversions. Conversion. And he is an example of the Scornful Lady by Johnson. At the end of the Scornful Lady by Johnson, the usurer, there is a conversion, a change of his mind. A usurer means a lover of money. But it so happened that he says, it so happened that some wild young fellow cheated him. So he, to prevent another young fellow to cheat him, he stops all this, he becomes a good man, and he is doing penance. So it's something that is unbelievable. You can't believe such a thing. That is overnight conversion. It is like if somebody presents Shylock at the end of Merchant of Venice, getting converted and becomes a saint. So we'll be praying to a saint Shylock. Such a thing will never happen. It cannot happen. If it happens, that is absurd. That's what it is. So these are the five reasons for which Lycidas is criticizing the, it's a critique of the English stage. Yes. So this is a prelude. Now comes the second part of this that we will see tomorrow only. And today, for the time being, we can see how he is preparing the audience to receive his ideas on the French drama and the French stage, especially Richelieu, Cardinal Richelieu, their patron, then the dramatist Corneille and Molière. Understand? So once again, the defects of this is the first part of Lycidas, defense of Lycidas by the French. First part is the criticism of the English stage. First, point one is double plot. too many people, too many characters, they don't know each other. Montague and Capulet, at the end they all come together like a mob, so it is very difficult to digest this. Second is mirth and passion mixed together. So that is just, it is a play and farce mixing together. This play and farce. It is, as we have already seen, it is a bedlam, he says. It's a play and farce, understand? It is purgative and restriction together. You cannot. No admiration, no passion, nothing. What is happening on the stage? The spectators don't know, and also the players don't know, the actors don't know. Then third is direct attack on Shakespeare. Shakespeare's historical plays for lack of unity and also sprawling, you know, it's so sprawling that your memory cannot hold. When you say unity of action, Aristotle has laid down this rule of unity of action, because the person who is seeing the drama should keep from beginning to the end in memory. Otherwise, how will you understand, how will you enjoy it? So the event should be such. So it should be say, running 2 hours or 3 hours or so. That's why Aristotle actually had not laid down that rule. That is a kind of rule derived from action, unity of action by the French dramatists. They are so scrupulous about it, so meticulous about it. That is all the three unities. And we will see when Neander criticizing or making fun of these unities and so on. Understand? And then you see historical place outside. There is no selection. All the events are being presented on the stage. He says some have to be, some. Even Horace gives the rule, decorum of the stage. That means something that causes aversion in you should not be presented on the stage. But the English has no discrimination. That is the thing. And then conversion. There are certain, like this Scornful Lady of Johnson, some plays are there, some dramas are there. Till the end, the person, the hero, or the main character undergoes conversion, and that is unbelievable. The narration and why is given and so on is unbelievable. These are the 5 points on which this Lycidius is criticizing the English stage. So tomorrow we will see what are the reasons why he praises the French. That we will see in the next class. Till then, bye. If you are not subscribed to my channel, I humbly request you to do that at the earliest. Thank you very much.